Is anyone on Tinder right now in this room? If you guys are not familiar with Tinder, Tinder is an app on your phone that you can download. Then you put pictures of yourself up there, and then you look at other people's pictures around you. And if you both like each other's pictures, then you can talk to each other. It's like any other dating website, but it's for people who can't read. But we overdo it sometimes. Like I was at this bar after a show one night. This place is packed. It's like 150 people, standing room only. So I'm trying to squeeze my way up to the bar to get a drink. I look over, there's this guy hunched over the bar, staring at his phone on Tinder. I'm like, dude, what are you doing? You're staring at a simulation of the place you are in right now. You came to this bar so you could swipe your head to the right and left and maybe find people in your immediate area who might be interested in you, and you're staring at your phone? That's like stopping in the middle of stealing a car to go play Grand Theft Auto. I think online dating is great. I really do. I think the one thing I think online dating does ruin, though, is meeting stories. Like, there are no more good meeting stories if you meet online. Like, my parents have the best meeting story. You know, like all great love stories, this one revolves around square dancing. Which apparently, if you weren't doing blow in the 70s, was the only thing left. Because my parents did not live in a big town, both square danced, and didn't know each other. Like, there were multiple square dancing, I don't know if you can say circles. There were groups. There were multiple square dancing groups. So eventually they meet at a party, find out that they both square dance. So my dad, in all of his smoothness, says, I know about four other women who square dance, so I'll probably be calling you about once a month. So my parents go square dancing, it goes well. A month later, because my dad's a man of his word, a month later they go out again, they have dinner. My dad's driving my mom home after dinner and says to her, 2 dates in, says to her, you know what? I was just talking to a friend of mine about this, felt like I wasn't ready to settle down, but now that I've met you, I feel like I could. 2 dates in. So he's trying to make plans with my mom for the weekend, she's being evasive. They get back to her place, her roommate comes out and tells her that her boyfriend called and needed to be picked up at the bus station. Because what my mother had neglected to tell my father is that she'd had a boyfriend for 3 years who was off at school and would be visiting for the weekend. So my dad eventually pulls this out of my mom and 2 dates in drops an ultimatum. Says, you need to make a choice right now. It's either him or me. And then drove my mom to the bus station where she told her boyfriend to get back on the bus. They got married 6 weeks later. They were married 35 years, they had 5 kids. That is a great story. What do you tell your kids if you meet online? It's like, Dad, how did you meet Mom? Like, I was flipping through profile pictures at 3 a.m. And I was like, what the hell? I like Arrested Development and Indian food too. Let's hang out. You know when it's right, you just know. You just know. She had me a duck face.